His Excellency Yoweri Museveni paid a state visit to the Republic of South Africa yesterday at the invitation of His Excellency Cyril Ramaphosa, the President of the Republic of South Africa. The purpose of the visit was to review and strengthen the current state of bilateral relations and evaluate progress made in the implementation of agreed areas of cooperation, whilst exploring cooperation in other areas of mutual interest. President Ramaphosa, who warmly welcomed General Museveni to South Africa, highly commended the cordial and bilateral relationship existing between the two African countries.
South Africa remains keen on investing in Uganda, and particularly in a number of sectors, in banking, retail, telecommunications. We hope that Ugandan businesses will also find their way in investing in South Africa for the mutual benefit of our two countries.
President Ramaphosa also praised President Museveni for being a true Pan-Africanist, pointing out Uganda's role in South Africa's liberation struggle.
On behalf of the people of South Africa, allow me to express our appreciation to the people of Uganda for their contribution to our freedom. Relations between our two countries are based on the principles of mutual respect, the promotion of Pan-Africanism, and a commitment to human rights and also to the emancipation of women.
President Museveni also congratulated the people of South Africa for the struggle they waged against colonialism. He particularly paid tribute to the youth who paid the price with their lives in 1966 to ensure that the country achieves freedom.
That uprising really gave us hope. Even we who were outside, we could see that things were going to change. Now, when we had capacity to do some small contribution, 1989, when the ANC had some issues in Angola, we did not hesitate.
Museveni disclosed that Uganda is endowed with a favorable agricultural climate, which could fuel South Africa's high agro-based products demand.
Near the equator, we have two rainy seasons. That's why these Ugandans are lazy, you see, because life is very easy for them. You don't have to work very hard, you know. Even a fool can survive in Uganda. So those agro-based that South Africa may need, cheap. There are plenty.
The two leaders witnessed the signing of memorandums of understanding that covered social, economic, legal, and scientific sectors. Uganda's Minister of Foreign Affairs, General Abubakar Jeje Odong, signed many of the MOUs on behalf of the government of Uganda, and the ministers of South Africa signed on behalf of their country. These included Sisulu Lindiwe, the Minister of Tourism, Thoko Didiza, the Minister of Agriculture, among others. President Museveni later visited the Freedom Park, where the history of the heroes who fought against apartheid and for the independence of South Africa is showcased. Museveni paid respect to the fallen heroes.